Okay, then Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So this is Java from the Sun Microsystems. So if we talk about the Java, once again, I have this open here. So we said it is from the Sun Microsystem. Where is that pen? Draw. Okay. So it was the Sun Microsystem, and we had what's called an oak, right? We created the oak, and it was, we talked a lot of things yesterday. You can see the video also. So Nicholas Wirth, who has a Pascal, created Pascal. And the important thing which was there, because we said we have the write once and run everywhere. Whatever. You write it once and run it everywhere. It is because of the idea which Nicholas Wirth has done in a Pascal. And we took that idea from the, who was the guys who have done it? Who Java started Java? Peter Norton. Peter Norton, right? And one more guy, who was that? Yesterday I told you. Who, Mujid? Kali to pada? Hanji. No, no, Nicholas Wirth is the Pascal. Peter Norton, or kon tha? Jisne green project shuru kiya. Maine kaha tha green project. They started the green project. And they call it oak. Go through this yesterday's video, okay? Admit Hyder Ali. Go through the yesterday's video and do it and tell me. I will be sending some MCQs on the admit. I will send some MCQs on the Telegram. Okay. So, anyways, so we have what is called as a virtual machine concept. That's the important thing which is different in Java than the other languages, which we yesterday, you know, actually we did it, that we have a virtual machine. Because usually in the any program language like C, C++ you have done, you compile the code as per the hardware. Okay, is baat ko samajhna pure se. Ye kal main actually bata chuka hun, so you already know it now. Lekin usse kya hoga ki jab aapne code ko compile kiya aur aapne isko bana diya, ab machine specific, jis hisab se machine thi usi hisab se aapne usko. Hyder Ali, you have to keep your camera on, and Shah Zubair, please fix it so that I will take a pic of it, your camera. So when you convert, this is my machine, for example. It has its own registers, it has its own you know, stack, it has its own cache memory, it has its architecture, it has its instructional architecture, it has all of its different than if I have a MacBook, which is a Mac operating system, and it has its own processor. If I have got an Intel machine, if I got the AMD machine, that is totally different architecture than what we have in the Intel machine, or is a mobile processors. They're totally different processors. So that means if I am converting my program and running it, and how can it run on this machine? When I convert that code into the architecture of this machine. Shah Zubair. Okay, it's come up again. Do you understand? So when you convert, and it is the job of compiler and assembler who convert your code like abc.c or abc.cpp into the exe, executable code. The executable code is exactly as per this machine architecture, whatever it is hardware is. So that means if I have converted that recipe, that code, into the architecture of this machine, now if I have, for example, a different machine, say this is my different machine, it's not gonna run on this, right? It's not gonna run on this. Why? Because jo iska architecture tha, wo uska architecture nahi hai. So agar is hisab se banaya, to wo usme kahan chalega? Hai na? So that means when you write a code in C and convert it into executable code, it is not gonna run everywhere. It is going to run only on that machine or that kind of machine. Agar isi machine ka dusri copy hai, aisi machine us pe chalega bas. So it will not run on different architectures. So that means my code in C and C++ was not architecturally neutral, because we have converted that into the architecture. What are the architecture we have? So this was removed by the Nicholas Wirth, who invented the Pascal, that he created, we write, say he, what we say is, when you go for compilation, you actually do not convert it into executable code, because if you convert an executable code, that means that code has to run on that machine. So that code is machine dependent. Now it is completely that machine. But what we are saying is, we are, there are some chats coming up here. Let me see that. It is not connecting. Okay. Hyder Ali is saying audio. You have to try, because it is now the policy that anybody without cam has to be removed. But we just wait if there is some issue. Hyder Ali is still not here. Actually, he's gone, right? Anyways. So what I am saying is, now you are not writing to, it is like this thing that I said to you, hey, write an application to somebody, okay? And he understands English and he understands particular dialect. And you are writing the letter in English in that dialect, which is understood by that person exactly. But now there's the other person who is Chinese, who is what? So will that English letter with that particular dialect be understood by the Chinese person? No. Because whatever you have converted that into the architecture of that person, now we have a different architecture guy, the Chinese. He is not thoda easy. So he may not understand the English. So what you have to do? You have to recompile. So you need a different compiler which converts this code now as per the hardware of that Chinese person, right? Same as I have an Intel machine, I have the AMD, I have the MacBook and so on, and mobile, we have the embedded systems, a lot more. Now, we say write to the virtual machine, don't convert this code into the EXE, rather convert this into some intermediate code. ठीक है, एक kind of a recipe बना दो, जो हर machine के लिए same ही रहेगा, कि हम करें load from the RAM, load from this, but I am not giving the absolute address, कि अब वो कहाँ पर है. Because when you convert into executable code, you have to convert the logical address into absolute address, and you have to exactly write and read from the actual thing where it is. But I am saying keep it general, keep it what is called as a byte code, and later when you want to run it on a system, that system has the JVM in it. That system has in it what? JVM, Java Virtual Machine. And that JVM, I'm asking you a question, is that JVM machine dependent or machine independent? Yes.
Machine independent.
That is machine independent. Who is saying that?
Saifullah.
What others are saying? Is JVM machine independent or machine dependent?
Machine independent, because we use Java virtual machine pe bytecode. जो जावा को हम ये एग्जीक्यूटेबल कोड हम उस पे रन नहीं करते, उसमें हम बाइट कोड रन करते हैं, पर उसके बाद JVM में हम उसको .exe पे रन करते हैं.
The JVM we have is the machine dependent, because on one side you can write a code, for example you write something abc.java and you convert that into byte code using the Java compiler. So you have a Java compiler that converts to bytecode, and the bytecode is not executable code like what you had in your C, C++. Okay, this bytecode can be run anywhere, but if you have to run it on a particular machine, which may be Intel machine, it may be the AMD, okay, it may be something else, it may be the MacBook or something like that, okay. Now they have their JVM. Now this JVM is machine specific. It knows this machine. It is machine dependent JVM. The JVM which runs on your Intel will not run on your AMD. For AMD, you will have a different JVM. So when you install the JDK, I will show you the site. I told you yesterday, you have to install the JDK. Okay, JDK 16 we have these days. And JDK has JVM inside. They have two things, JRE and JVM. I will explain that. What is JR runtime and ROMit and what is JVM. Now, the JVM which is working for the Intel or which is working for 64-bit is not the same which is working even on a 32-bit. It is different, because JVM is machine dependent. It is specific to that machine only, because now this bytecode has to be converted into this machine code, which exactly runs on Intel, right? So if you want to run a Java, you need to have a Java runtime environment. Okay, so you don't worry about the programmer doesn't have to worry about I should convert this as per the Intel or I should convert it as per AMD. I will write a program and my Java compiler will create a bytecode. Okay, and then I can give this bytecode to every machine, but that machine should have its own JVM or Java runtime environment. In fact, to be specific, there should be Java runtime environment. I will tell you exactly what is that later on. First of all, I am running that bytecode on this machine now. This machine should have its own JVM or Java runtime environment there to convert this bytecode into this machine specific. Okay, actually run karna na machine ke upar. So this code has to be the machine specific. Executable code banana, jaise exe banta hai wahan pe, wo banana hi banana hai. Lekin hum pehle hi banate the. To usme fir main wo code leke kisi ko deta to wo wahan chalega nahi. क्योंकि वो इस मशीन स्पेसिफिक था. अब मैंने क्या किया, मैंने रन किया, मैंने मशीन डीम की एक वर्चुअल मशीन. मैंने एक पर्टिकुलर मशीन के ऊपर नहीं लिखा जैसे कि इंटेल की मशीन है. मैंने एक वर्चुअल मशीन को लिखा. मैं एक वर्चुअल मशीन को दे रहा हूँ कोड, उस हिसाब से कन्वर्ट कर रहा हूँ और दैट इज कॉल्ड अ बाइट कोड. ठीक है ना, तो उस बाइट कोड को लेके मैं अब इस मशीन पे अगर रन करना है तो यहाँ पे इसका JVM जो होगा वो इस मशीन के स्पेसिफिक होगा. वो मेरे इस कोड को कन्वर्ट करेगा इस मशीन के स्पेसिफिक. सो वो मेरा जॉब नहीं है, वो इस मशीन का जॉब है कि इसको अब कन्वर्ट कर रहा हूं. अब मैंने इसको दूसरे मशीन पे लगा लिया, मान लीजिए वो AMD मशीन है. अब AMD में वहां अपना JVM होगा, वो मशीन डिपेंडेंट होगा. ठीक है, उस मशीन का JVM होगा, वो इस मेरे बाइट को कन्वर्ट करेगा उसके स्पेसिफिक. डज इट मेक सेंस व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? समझ में आ रही है? सो इज JVM नाउ मशीन स्पेसिफिक, मशीन डिपेंडेंट और इंडिपेंडेंट? JVM
मशीन डिपेंडेंट.
सो व्हाट इज इंडिपेंडेंट हियर? मशीन डिपेंडेंट द कोड व्हिच इज क्रिएटेड बाय योर कंपाइलर, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज
बाइट कोड.
बाइट कोड.
सो एवरीबॉडी हैड अ बाइट आई थिंक, राइट? ओके, व्हाट इज दिस नाउ? A programming language. Java is a programming language, yes, just like C++ or Ruby, Python, and many others. It is a programming language, right? It is not something else. So what is Java language programming basically having is, it has this the language, it has the libraries, and it has a virtual machine. Okay, not only it has a language, it has also the libraries with it. It's not just a language, it's a whole platform. Okay, Java is more than a language because it has the libraries and it has the virtual machine in it. And we see the Java, it's an old language, but not that old. As you could see, Java is here, 1995, kick-started. Before that, we had these old languages. And after that also came a lot of languages, right? But still Java is kicking and it's going. Some people may think that, hey, Java will be dead, but it's not dead at all. And it's working like anything. And it's because Java's strength is, it's on every platform. Is it mobile? It is embedded, because I told you 99% of the systems are embedded systems. Like Cadillac, my i20 car, it has many computers in it. Okay, right? Processors in it. Some process getting oil from the carburetor, some process sensing the cameras, working with the cameras and beeping. There are a lot of sensors also in it. So if you see the modern cars, they have hundreds of computers working dedicatedly. There are today the buttons which, put up the button and it will do adaptive cruise control. Like your car is going, it sees the car in the front, it adjusts the speed, puts a brake of its own. And if you go to the America, there in the developed countries, there you are the autopilots. You just tell the destination. I was very young, perhaps 12th or something. There was some Arnold Schwarzenegger's movie. They were fighting and they were fighting together and they went into the car for while fighting. And he used some slang word or something. And car was saying destination unidentified. Destination unidentified. Basically, it was autopilot. The car thought ki they are giving me some destination. Okay? Because they were fighting and then using some slang word. So I didn't understood that time. But my demagus was clear. MK is one destination identified. What was the masla kya tha? And later on, when I joined the computer science, I understood ki bhai ki masla kya hai. Theek hai na? एनीवेज, सो इज जावा ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड और नॉट? इज जावा ऑब्जेक्ट
ओरिएंटेड? प्योरली ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड.
हु इज सेइंग प्योरली?
यस सर.
Who is saying
object
purely?
Not purely.
It's not purely object oriented because it has the primitive data types. It has the primitive data types like int, like char, and all. They are still there. Okay. Even though we have wrapper, I told you we have wrapper classes. We'll tell you later on. The wrapper classes wrap the int and make it as an object, as a class. But still, we have those primitive int, int, purana, jo seekha hai na. So this will not, Java will not be called as a purely object oriented. Because it's not completely object oriented. It has these primitive data types. Okay. But let's just say nearly everything, not like everything, but nearly everything is object. Because chota se primitive data types, chote se baki sara object. ठीक है? ये मेरी मन छोई थोड़ा बहुत. वरना ये अच्छा था. Okay. So. What should we do? So if we see, we saw that Java is Dr. Yasmin Shabid. Let me take later this call. Huh? Okay, we have 10 minutes only. Because if I call it, then 10 minutes will be going. It's from the college and I will see. So what I'm saying is, we say Java is everywhere because we have different versions of Java. J2SE, I told you. Standard edition, which is used for your computers and desktop applications. We got J2EE. What is J2EE? Enterprise edition. This is my development. जो मैं बता रहा था मेरे आप से वो है J2EE. That I done J2ME mobile edition. I have my one of the playlist on J2ME because I have a certification on it. Mobile edition. Okay. And then there are a lot of. We can have the applet. We can have the servlets. And Java is everywhere. And 99% I told you it is an embedded systems. Where the Java is used, and because of its portability, because we can generate a very small code in case of Java, so that makes it very portable and very, because it's a very small code, so we don't have a big RAMs and big memories in case of an embedded systems. They have a very little memory, so we need a code which takes less space, and that's why Java gets, you know, it becomes famous because of this thing, right? And it has taken virtually everything from the other guys like C, C++, and Pascal, and many more languages. So it's everywhere, right? Okay. Now, it is also evolving. Java is slowly evolving. It is evolving. I told you that we have a versions of Java. Like today, we have add up these. We have seen it from Wikipedia yesterday, up to Java 16. Today it is 16. Okay. Now, only difference here is we have not only evolved in the language, we have added up a lot of features while we evolved here, okay? But usually we use it to call JDK 1.0, 1.1, 1.2, but when it's 1.4, after that we started calling 5.0. But when it's 6 comes, we drop it that OM. We call it Java SE 6. Okay, I'm talking of standard edition, which is the desktop applications where we create. This is where the core Java comes up. That's called core Java. Okay. Then 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14, and up to 16. Now today we are on a 16. So you have to go to the Google and say JDK 16 and download that. Okay. And you can go to Wikipedia to add up all those things, the rest ones. So this is your Java source code. So if you write, we may not be writing today because it's only 7 minutes left. So Java source code, we have whatever we write it in a file and we name it as a .java, like .c, .cpp. Here we have .java. And important thing is the main you write that has to be inside the class. And each file has its own public class and the file name and the public class name has to be same. अभी घबराने का नहीं है, जब हम करेंगे ना इजी लिखेगा, अभी कुछ आपको कंफ्यूजन मत होगा. वैसे आपने तो ये किया होगा मेरे ख्याल से, इन बीसी भूल गए होंगे. जो फाइल का नाम होगा वही जावा का नाम होगा एंड क्लास का नाम होगा, और जो मेन क्लास है इसके अंदर मेन है, ये मेन क्लास है, इसके अंदर आपका मेन है, ठीक है. और जो आपके इस क्लास का नाम है वही नाम आप फाइल का भी रखेंगे, सो कीप दैट थिंग इन माइंड. और क्लास का नाम जब आप देंगे, you will keep first letter capital. अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज अ क्लास, ठीक है. सो अब अगर मैंने ये सोर्स कोड बनाया डॉट वट एवर डॉट जावा, मैं फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैंने इसका नाम रखा फर्स्ट डॉट जावा. सो पहले मैंने एक फाइल बनाई होगी जिसका नाम होगा फर्स्ट डॉट जावा. अभी मैंने गड़बड़ किया, एफ शुड बी कैपिटल. फर्स्ट डॉट जावा इस फाइल का नाम होगा, ठीक है ना. और इस फाइल के अंदर मेरे पास होगा फर्स्ट डॉट पब्लिक क्लास होगा जिसका नाम होगा फर्स्ट पब्लिक क्लास फर्स्ट. और जो आपका मेन प्रोग्राम है वो इसी क्लास के अंदर होगा, वो बाद में पढ़ेंगे, कल पढ़ेंगे प्रोग्राम, सिंपल आपको समझ आएगा, अभी आप छोड़ो इसको फिलहाल. सो फर्स्ट डॉट जावा जो मेरा है ये सोर्स कोड है इस फाइल के अंदर. आई यूज ए जावा कंपाइलर टू कंपाइल दैट कोड इन टू एन कोड विच इज द बाइट कोड. तो यहां पे होगा हमारे पास फर्स्ट, मैं कल दिखाऊंगा आपको लाइव कि वहां पे कैसे बनाएंगे हम, फर्स्ट फोल्डर में कैसे बनाए फर्स्ट डॉट क्लास. नाउ फर्स्ट डॉट क्लास जो आप जावा कंपाइलर ने आपको बनाया, दिस इज योर बाइट कोड. एंड आई एम आस्किंग टू द कोनेन, इज दिस बाइट कोड मशीन डिपेंडेंट और इंडिपेंडेंट? राइट इन द चैट विंडो, राइट इन द चैट विंडो, यूज चैट विंडो. इज दिस बाइट कोड मशीन डिपेंडेंट और मशीन इंडिपेंडेंट? So he is saying machine independent, right? So you are writing as if you are writing to a virtual machine. So you are writing to JVM. So whatever we are writing, we are writing to JVM. We are not writing to the exact some particular Intel architecture or to particular whatever. So whatever we are writing, our compiler is converting it to the intermediate code and not to the particular. But यहाँ पे Java कमांड लिखा है. And we have a Java C command, J-A-V-A-C. I will show you tomorrow in a folder when we download JDK. And आप एक काम करेंगे, आप JDK करेंगे और Eclipse download करेंगे आप, ठीक है ना. फिलहाल मैं Notepad में आपको पहले दिखाऊंगा ताकि आपको उसका ये हो जाए, फिर Eclipse में हम करेंगे. So download Eclipse latest version and download JDK 16 according to your machine. आज आप वो करेंगे, Google में ऊपर लिखेंगे JDK 16, JDK download, वो खुद ही दिखाएगा आपको Oracle की साइट and you download that, ठीक है ना. और Eclipse भी ऊपर कहेंगे इक्लिप्स डाउनलोड, वो आपको दिखाएगा कहाँ, तो उसको डाउनलोड करके रखेंगे आप. बिकॉज बाई टुमारो फर्स्ट वी डू इट इन अ नोटपैड, ठीक है ना. वी यूज कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट टू कंपाइल एंड देन लेटर ऑन जब आप कंफर्टेबल हो जाओगे, समझ आ जाएगा कैसे होता है, फिर हम इक्लिप्स पे जाएंगे. नाउ हियर टू रन इट, ओके, वी हैव अ JVM. एंड JVM में भी एज पर द मैक और यूनिक्स और विंडोज व्हाटएवर इट इज, दे हैव इट्स ओन JVM. Okay, and they convert this code as per the hardware, and you can then run it. Does it make sense? We have 3 minutes only, but we add up things here. So, what you will download is you will download a JDK. You will download what? Java Development Kit 16.0, but whatever point, whatever that is, version is. That's the latest. You will download Java Development Kit. That's for the programmer, not for the running. If you want to run a Java code and give it to my system, there must be a Java runtime environment and it will run your code for that. It's not executable banate ho, fir executable aap run karte ho kisi bhi system mein, theek hai. Lekin wo kisi bhi system pe nahi chalta hai, wo usi system pe chalega, usi kism ke system pe chalega, lekin jo aapka ye byte code hai wo kahin pe bhi chalega, lekin Java runtime environment hona chahiye. So Java runtime environment aapke paas pehle hona chahiye. You need to have a Java runtime environment. एक जावा रन टाइम एनवायरनमेंट होता क्या है, एक आपके इसमें पहले JVM होता है, जावा वर्चुअल मशीन होता है, ठीक है, और आपके पास लाइब्रेरीज होती है और आपके पास APIs होते हैं, एप्लीकेशन प्रोग्रामिंग इंटरफेसेस, ठीक है, जो इनको चलाएंगे. JDK में JRE से एक्स्ट्रा क्या होता है, आपके पास डेवलपमेंट टूल्स होते हैं. फॉर प्रोग्रामर वी नीड JDK, फॉर रनिंग ए कोड वी डोंट नीड, वी नीड JRE ओनली. For running a code, we need JRE. For this thing, we use the development and so on. Example, I mean, if bug jayega na, mujhe I have to take care because I have 1 minute only left. I need to take care. Zahid Beg, open up your camera. Shah Zubair, Sajid Mushtaq, where are your cameras off? I didn't take a picture. I have forgot to take the picture. हाँ जाहिद शाह जुबैर एंड साजिद एंड माजिद एंड हूएवर प्लीज ओपन अप योर कैम. यार कैमरा ओपन करो ना, क्या मसला है? कितनी बार मैं बोलूंगा एक ही बात. शाह जुबैर और अंधकार साजिद मुश्ताक लापता है. शाह जुबैर साहब कैमरा तरावा जल्द. व्हाट इज हिज नेम साजिद मुश्ताक. मुश्ताक साहब छिवाज के ना
नोचन शायद की
बस छिवाज के ना
कैमरा ऑन है.
किसका?
जुबैर बोल रहा है कैमरा ऑन है.
आने मुझे मास्क क्या था बदल मगर जुबैर साहब उसे कैमरा क्या था दिलील. सो एनीवेज लेट्स okay we were here. So we got the JDK ye chali bhi nahi hai bomb rojun kiya thi karo paga continue.
So sir, we have power reset karna hai
ji
sir, path reset karna hai JDK.